It's no secret I've been a fan of ToDoIst for a while, so much so that I can't say it. It's no secret I've been a fan of Google Calendar. But what if you took those two applications and mixed it in with another really nice note-taking app that is simple and will not cost you any more money? That's what I'm here for. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I know. Hold the applause. So the way that you're going to structure this is actually very simple and works, in my opinion, pretty well in a segmented system. So first and foremost, what you're going to do is you're going to take color coding into account. So for me, I always have color coding examples for these videos, and I have my work, my perspective, which is my business, growth, and life. So here you can change any project's colors. So I'm going to change this to yellow right here. And if you want to make a new project, you can do that. And essentially what you're going to do is you're going to take the ToDoIst project system and you're going to utilize that for different segments of the task that you're going to take into account. And then what you can do on top of that is obviously utilize ToDoIst amazing functionality from a mobile perspective, from a capture perspective, like for example, in the settings, if you're on the desktop app, you can go to advanced here. And then it'll do quick add. Somebody put a comment recently about how they were confused how they didn't see this. That's because they were on the web app. You need to be on like the desktop or Mac app to see this. And I changed mine to Alt Q. So if I go anywhere, press Alt Q, it'll be able to capture it. So obviously I can just do example task for tomorrow. If we go back to ToDoIst, see, it'll put a date to it. But say I wanted to add it to a different project, change the project here, or I can do a hashtag, do work, and then it'll save it right here for me. An example workflow you could go through is just capturing a bunch of different tasks throughout the day and then assigning them to different parts of your life. And then possibly looking at the today view and grouping them by project and then sorting them by, I would say, project as well. So contextually how this would work is that, for example, if you think your work or your rise productive are more important, you would probably move them in whatever order makes sense. So for example, I think work is less important, then I'd go here and my rise productive would be above that. And then the team and books would obviously be at the top. If I got rid of this one, it would only show what's left. But then if I put work back on top, sorting would adjust. And you could also group it by the due date as well. So if it's all overdue or by default, the different priorities that you want, whatever way that you want to sort this, it's your option. But I personally like grouping it by different projects I have and then sorting it by due date within that project. You could also do different views for the specific subsections of that project. There's a bunch of different ways that you can utilize the filters, and you can check out my ToDoIst course to figure out more on how to do that sort of stuff. Now, the great thing about this system is that you can quickly and easily go to settings, integrations, and there's a free Google Calendar sync. So say, for example, I go to here, see that if I, for example, add a calendar, you can pick a specific project. That's what I like to do personally. And then what you can contextually do is pick things like work, and you can pick the default event duration as well. And then ToDoIst tasks without a time. What will they do? Will they sync or not sync? Say, for example, I go back to this one, which I already have implemented. I go to my Google Calendar. You'll see this example task that I always like to put as a joke. Make me happy. Here's an example task from the work sync that I have. And then there's this other one right here that's an example. So you can see that this is that all day situation. But for example, if I go to Rise Productive here and make an example task today at 5 p.m. and another example task tomorrow at 5 p.m. that it's synced right here. And what I like to do is take the color here and match it to what I have in ToDoIst so that it syncs up. Now you can use this and organize your different parts of your system with time blocking. So for example, you can time block different parts of your day. So for this work section, rise productive, growth, life, what I did in my life, and what I do for my business as well, since my personal and business calendar are kind of in sync, is that I utilize these different blocks to signify the time that I'm spending doing things. And you can either have these time blocks open and then fill them with different ToDoIst tasks, or you can just color code one individual calendar. It's all up to you, but I really like having this visualization and then inputting tasks on top of it if I was using a system like this. So implement time blocking and this ToDoIst system. And then on top of that, the last component would be the note-taking application that you would use. So in OneNote, what's really nice about it is the fact that you can segment it into different notebooks. And for me, what I would do is I would segment it to different things. Like for example, obviously I'm gonna pick this one, do Rise Productive, free notebook. You can change the name of it to, for example, Life. This one could be nicknamed to Rise Productive. This one can also have sections within it. So any of these different notebooks can have sections and section groups. So if I had a section for podcasts, you can see there was a YouTube one, there was a podcast one. I can then take two of these and change the color if I wanted. So if all of these were red, just so that I could signify it for my own brain, take red. Then within it, I go here, add different pages, for example, podcast episodes. And what I really like about OneNote is that you can have multiple pages grouped together. So you can make this one a subpage of this one. So for example, it could just have a podcast episode one, and then you could make a research section, and then you can add another page or outline. You can sort these different things by alphabetical, date created, date modified. And OneNote is a very simple system. It takes a lot of the core functionality of like Microsoft Word and sort of levels that up a bit. For example, as you can see on the screen, I am actually able to take notes via dictation, which is really convenient. Don't like how it missed some things, but that's just how dictation software works. Even when you're using a microphone like this and having a really nice, deep, and clear voice. You missed the "and." How did you miss the "and"? I don't get that with dictation sometimes. But anyways, this is a very simple system as well, where you can mark different things here as important. You can mark different things with question marks. You can create tags even, can be used throughout the notebook as well. And by color coding these different notebooks and color coding your ToDoist and your Google Calendar, you're gonna have a synced system that will really organize your life in a way that is simple, and the price on this can be really cheap. You can only pay $4 a month for ToDoist Pro. You can use ToDoist free version and you'll be pretty much fine, especially in the sense that Google Calendar integration is one of the best free applications that you're gonna find around. A lot of these apps require you to have Google Calendar, sense that it needs the main app to have Pro, and it's really annoying. Like Taskade does it, TickTick does it, and I'm just like, come on, Taskade, you're charging the beta. You were charging money for the beta for the Google Calendar integration, and I'm never going to be okay with that. You did that. I'm not going to be okay if you don't check out this video on how to improve your productivity even more.